Welcome back, everybody. Filipinos talking basketball. Anthony Davis, the brow. The six wants you. Mark wants you. Mark, why should Anthony Davis come here?
It's just, I'm going to put it in one statement. Teams or fans, sports fans whatsoever, they don't remember teams that just have a longevity of making in the playoffs. People will remember you if you're a team that went to the finals and win a championship. If you have a chance to win a championship, if you have a chance to pieces to get players that can help you win a championship, even for 1 year, you would go for it. Because how many teams have won a championship? Out of the 30 teams, Boston, Golden State, Cleveland, Spurs. You can name a lot of teams that did not win, that haven't won a championship. Raptors is one of them. I mean, Charlotte. More than half of the team in the NBA has never won a championship. Mm-hmm. So would you rather be the kind of player that a team that has this, you know, longevity in terms of success, but then never make it past the second round, never make it past the finals, never make it to the finals? Mm-hmm. I'd rather have it, you know, if I have the pieces to put it together, that even though I'll get Kawhi for a rental, I'll get Davis for half a season, but then make it to the finals.
Yeah. Yeah.
You never know what winning does. Winning solves, cures everything. Oh, if they win, make it to the finals and lose in six games or lose in like seven games, Kawhi will change his mind. Davis will change his mind because Davis has been focused on winning. He wanted to have a legacy. And if he's on a team that actually helped him get there, like, why is he going to say no?
So you're a risk taker right now. You're short term thinker.
In sports, you have to be.
Yes.
No one's gonna remember a team that had Utah Jazz had a long season of success back in the 90s with Stockton and Malone, but no one ever remembered them because they never won a championship for 10 straight years. Never won a championship with them.
Do you think winning is enough? Do you think?
I don't know.
You mentioned
because I'm a Sixers fan. Yeah. I went through the process. That's very hard to say. Like, oh wait. I'm not sure about trading for him Sixers. So we can offer him something. If we offer Jimmy Butler and something, I will take that. But if we have two rental and in the next season, we, like Raptors, don't have draft picks and don't have any pieces anymore, just role players, that's going to be hard. That's going to be just like what Pacers are doing right now. Mm-hmm. I thought they will be okay, but they're having a hard time working with the team because everything surrounds Victor Oladipo. So for you, I understand, because obviously Raptors never been to the finals.
Land. No.
And then
this is
not
their
just,
best chance. Yeah, the East sucks.
Yeah. Not just Raptors, Blue Jays. I mean, Blue Jays won like 1960s or something like that. Or Maple Leafs didn't even.
This is the best chance they have.
So I understand where he's coming from, but for me, that's hard to say yes to that one.
Yeah, you're not with the risk.
You
want to make sure you're
because I went through the process.
But this is different from the the process was they never had the pieces, really the pieces that the Raptors have in terms of talents and assets. For them, they took a risk on drafting a bunch of young players and assuming one of them would grow. Yeah. Whereas with the Raptors, they were careful in terms of building building the assets that they had, and they developed them, right? So it wasn't so they were picked and then hopefully one turns out. It was they pick and develop these players into, and so they were able to acquire assets because they were careful with it and they were they took their time with it. Yeah, but the opportunity where you're never going to get a chance to get a player of this caliber like Anthony Davis. Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's rare. Yeah. To get Kawhi was already a rare occasion. Yeah. You get two in one season, 1 year or the next, that's impossible to have. And if you have the right pieces to make, I would go for it because the best thing about the Raptors team is that even though they suck, Canadians have no choice but to watch them.
Yeah,
so even if they do it this year and make it to the finals and let's say one of them leaves, like maybe Davis or Kawhi leaves, you have no choice. Yeah. The Raptors is still going to be the team that Canadians are going to watch. Like, they're still but the thing is that I think more of us will appreciate it more because they actually went for
Went for it. Okay.
A lot of players in the Raptors left because we did not take the risk.
Yeah.
Vince Carter left because we didn't put enough talents on him. T-Mac left, right? Chris Bosh left because of us. These are really good superstar, all-star players that left us because we never took that risk. And this is the first time we could do it. Why not?
You make
a
great
point. To be honest, I think Masai is a really good GM when he traded Carmelo when he was in Denver.
Exactly.
And now I think, just trust Masai. So I guess if you guys are Raptors fan, just
believe it. Reading my mind.
But for me, it's different because I know how the process
is. As much
is.
As I like Siakam, as much as I like his improvement in terms of how he's grown as a player this season, Davis is a lot better in terms of like his game is fully polished, both for offensive and defensive end. He doesn't need the ball in his hand a lot of times. He's a pick and roll, pick and pop off the offensive glass. That's all you're going to need from him. And I mean, to have him to pair with Kawhi and Lowry, and if you keep, like, I think Ibaka, you're going to have still, that's a pretty good defensive team, right? And you're going to still have Danny Green, even if you lose Siakam, OG, DeLon, and a couple of your first round pick, and maybe JV. You're still going to have a pretty deep team because you have, Van Fleet, you're still going to have Greg Monroe off the bench, DJ Miles. So that's still a pretty good team. Mm-hmm.
So in summary, Mark, you're going to tell Masai to go for it.
Yes.
Go for it.
And let's that trade, Masai.
You guys have the second best GM behind Danny Ainge, because Danny Ainge, you guys already know.
He has a lot of The thing is, like, if they don't go for it now,
someone else.
Summertime, Boston can, because of that rule with regards to Kyrie. Yeah. Just because they have Kyrie, they can't make a trade for Davis right now. So if they wait for it, for the opportunity, or they don't go for it by summer, Celtics gonna have the most asset and the most talent to offer New Orleans to get Davis, and it's not even gonna be close. But right now, the Raptors has a better package to offer to New Orleans as opposed to the Lakers, just because New Orleans doesn't want to deal with it because of, they think that they tampered, like LeBron tampered with the rule. So
$20,000 fine
with the Lakers. No. So I think New Orleans right now is more willing to deal Davis. So to a team like a Raptor than the Lakers during this period where the trade deadline ends. But once the summer hits, Boston is up at it.
So we're going to have both the claw and the brow if this goes through, which will be, again, kind of scary for me because, like you said, two short-term rentals. Yeah. But again, you have make a good point. Winning does change everything.
Winning gives everything.
But you think it's worth it when it comes to, because I remember Colangelo for the Sixers traded up for Markelle Fultz, and that got him fired.
Yeah. Two different scenarios.
Yeah.
Markelle Fultz is not proven. Davis is proven that he can play in the NBA. Two different scenarios. Even if I lose a draft pick to get someone that's proven, I'd rather have that than draft a player that you don't know what's going to happen. You don't know Lonzo was going to be good. You don't know Kuzma was going to be good when they drafted. You don't know Donovan was going to be good. Rookies are just too unpredictable. Whereas if you have a player that's have proven a 5-7 year established all-star career in the NBA, I would trust that.
Okay. So you would take the risk.
I would take that.
I think Mark would sleep at night if we went for it and we lost both of them, but I think you'd sleep at night. Like, this was the year
the
where we tried.
I think would sleep well at night knowing that
we tried it.
We are willing to take risks, which we've never done as a franchise for a very long time. We've lost players because we weren't able to take
LeBron
the risk.
No LeBron anymore, too.
We've lost players because we weren't able to, take that risk. Yeah. We lost Chris Bosh. We lost T-Mac. We lost, imagine when we had Chris Bosh and T-Mac, all these kind of players, and we surrounded them with talent. You could have, gone far.
To make a good point, I'm kind of inspired.
Yeah, actually, good point.
Well, that ends our show for today. Marky Mark, anything you'd like to say? Shout-outs? Yeah.
Well, shout out to our fans. Keep following us on our Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, Pinoy Crossover. We love you guys. You guys have been awesome with the commenting and sharing of our posts. Just keep it up.
Yep. And James, anything you'd like to say? Shout outs?
Same thing. Family in Philippines, Canada, and US. And I just want to thank you guys for having me 2 weeks in a row.
Thank you for coming. And we're going to be more active on our social media platforms. James is actually writing a piece for us as well. So there'll be so much content coming up. And make sure you comment and subscribe to our YouTube channel and all our social media platforms. Till then, stay ballin'.